For more than a decade, the journey of Godsmack has taken us from some of the smallest clubs in Boston to some of the largest stages across the world. Through four records and thousands of gigs, we have crushed audiences all over the world doing what we do best.
Rock and f***ing roll.
Then there was silence. For 2 years, we've been resting, we've been writing, we are fully reloaded.
And now, we're back!
Strap yourself in and join us for the making of Saints and Sinners, Godsmack 5.
We've been writing the record throughout the year. You know, we started back in February. You know, we had taken some time off after the four tour, and I did a solo project for a little while. The guys did a solo project.
The break, you know, the whole break, almost 2 years off, you know, and we did one small tour each year just because we were going crazy, sitting around, what do? Let's do something, let's go play.
When we got back together, just from being away from that style of music, at least for me, because my solo record is very diverse and doesn't even have electric guitar on it. It was just kind of an inspiration in itself, taking a break to come back and write some really big, really big songs. I was ready to expand and hear some outside opinions on the songwriting and stuff like that. And usually, you know, I'm so in control of like the writing the music or writing the lyrics and that kind of thing that I feel like sometimes the well goes dry, and I wanted to just experiment and bring someone else in who I know has good credentials and has wrote and produced some really great albums. When I had talked about some producers that I wanted to work with, Shannon had brought up Dave Fortman.
Who's that?
Got the mighty Dave Fortman producing, who had made it before in a band called Ugly Kid Joe. I played with him for 5 years, rolled around the world with him, and loved the guy as like one of the funniest dudes ever.
I like being filmed, dude. What's next for me? Acting? I told the last crew it's the hills, dude, or nothing. I'm on the hills next week.
Dave knows that if this record doesn't go anywhere, then he's gonna be at the Comedy Store down on Sunset.
That's my next move, man. If not the hills.
All his fucking shit, why he failed.
My insurance plan is right here in these cameras. I'm going big, I'm going to the hills, or one of the, like, whatever the next killer, the city, or what's another one? City is the new one, right?
I'm mixing my pants off, is that cool?
After he met Dave, it was pretty much over, because Dave's just a real pleasant guy to be around and real funny and makes you feel comfortable in all ways, you know?
Somebody in the control room went running last night. Y'all, that's me.
Oh.
Yeah, me. Dave Fortman. I went running.
Come on.
Dude, I ran up, down the hills, sprinted, all kinds of shit. I feel great, Oakwoods.
You ran last night?
Yeah, I like midnight run kind of deal.
Wow.
And go to bed, yeah.
Yeah, that's cool.
I dig it.
It's just, you got all the reflectors and the blinking lights and shit.
Well, you know the little biker shorts? I have like a full set of pants that are running pants that are tight. Yeah.
I love those.
You ought to see my little sausage in them too. It's so cute.
That,
it's like an acorn fucking held up in a sack.
A belly, a little ass cheek. Mm.
That's cool. Little, they have two ass folds in the back.
What color?
Complicating.
Complicating is a different word.
Complicating is what happens when you run at midnight with little booty shorts on.
This record, we decided that we didn't want any serenities or voodoos or hollows or stuff like that on the record. We just, you know, we never really put out just a full-on badass in-your-face record.
Yeah, we wanted this one to be heavy. We stepped into it saying this is heavy. This can be our heavy record. You know, we want it to be heavy. I mean, Metallica is obviously a huge influence on all of us.
By going go-ga-ta, go-ga-ta, go-ga-ta-ta-ta-ta. So bonky, da go go go, pa pa, song da da dong, ba da 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 da, go go ta da, go go ta da, go go ta da da da.
You know, but I think, you know, we went for groove heavy, where Metallica is going back to the thrash heavy roots, you know, the speed metal. Yeah, dude.
Fuck yeah.
We've been writing the record throughout the year. You know, we started back in February, and then we were writing for a couple of months, and then Crewfest called, and we went out and ran that for a couple of months. And then when we got back, we took a couple weeks off and then got back into our rehearsal facility out here in Burbank, California. And once we got all the songs written and we felt like we had the record, we moved into the studio here in Hollywood.
And we work hard. We work 12, 14 hour days, and we just work.
What's up, my boy?
Bob? Here we are, trying to create the biggest record that we've ever had. Like, we brought in Dave Fortman, who's a hell of a producer. He's done Evanescence and some amazing big records. You know, every band in their career has had that one record that really shined. With AC/DC, it was Back in Black. Zeppelin 4, Metallica, the Black Album. You know, there was always that moment where they just fucking dominated the planet on that record. And we really feel that the stars are kind of lining up right now, because rock is really on an upswing. And again, it all kind of roots back to what we're doing right now. Let's start tuning America in and having Godsmack TV. Let's start showing them that, you know, we're active in the studio, we're recording this record, we're working with so-and-so. Leading up to the whole thing, we're like, wow, this is Godsmack. Like, because when it hits the arenas, it's just massive.
Usually on each record, I might not like a song or a song too here. This record, I like them all.
This is Shannon rocking What If.
A professional dessert eater.
I'm trying to bring chocolate into the vegetable world.